I'm David Hasselhoff, and I'd like to welcome you to the top 50 power ballads here on VH1. Now, I know what you're thinking. I don't listen to power ballads. My record collection only contains techno and Dr. Dre. Well, if you're not man enough to admit that Whitney Houston's I Will Always Love You makes the hair on the back of your neck stand up, or that Steven Tyler's Crazy makes you want to reach for your air guitar, that's your problem. So, just to warm you up, I thought I'd kick things off with me. 20 years younger, a lot longer hair, nice duster, with my power ballad, Looking for Freedom. It's number one for 8 weeks in Germany. Sometimes a power ballad is so powerful, it's impossible to follow it up, causing the singer to become a one-hit wonder. That happened to Jennifer Rush, Alana Miles, and our next artist, John Farnham. His song, The Voice, was a huge hit and looked to propel him straight into the realms of superstardom. The trouble was, he used bagpipes, and once you've done bagpipes, there's nowhere to go from there. If you try releasing another song and you don't pull off something pretty big out of the bag like cymbals or a glockenspiel, it's going to be anticlimactic. Anyway, here he is at number 47 with The Voice.
Good evening.
Hi, you're watching Power Ballads here on VH1 with me, David Hasselhoff. You know, to perform a power ballad, you need to have a big voice and a strong song and the ability to carry off shoulder pads. For some people, it's just never going to happen, like Dido's one, Sade's another. But then, there are others that can only sing power ballads and were clearly born wearing shoulder pads, like these two ladies. You know, this song was originally written for Stevie Nicks by Bernie Taupin, but fell into the hands of the Wilson sisters and gave them a number one hit. They are at our number 43 in our chart. This is Heart with These Dreams. Hi, you're watching the top 50 power ballads here on VH1 with me, David Hasselhoff. At number 40, we have a German band who first launched themselves onto the rock scene back in 1965. And these guys are still going strong today. You know, I have a soft spot for these guys as we both released tracks the same year the Berlin Wall came down. And they both became unofficial anthems for the opening of the Iron Curtain. I had the honor of performing Looking for Freedom in front of a million people on New Year's Eve in 1989. I'll never forget that night, and I'll never forget my buddies, the Scorpions. Here they are with the Winds of Change. All right, we're counting down the top 50 power ballads here on VH1. Now, the trouble with heavy rock bands releasing power ballads is that it can launch them into a whole new market, which is fine until the unsuspecting new fan buys tickets to their gigs on the strength of the power ballad. This was the case when Metallica released Nothing Else Matters. Thousands of fans showed up expecting a pleasant, lighter, waving experience, only to end up having a very different experience. So, at number 37, here are Metallica in a slightly less contentious mood. This is Nothing Else Matters. For those of you who've just joined us, we're counting down the top 50 power ballads here on VH1. You know, if a band really can't pull off a big dramatic video with a great storyline and a big budget, there is another option. They shoot the same video they would have done for one of their usual heavy rock songs and just slow the footage down. You know, I have to say, there's a lot to be said for slow motion shots, especially when running. Some people stand in the... Anyway, moving on. Poison at number 33 with Every Rose Has Its Thorns. I'm David Hasselhoff, and you're watching the top 50 power ballads. You know, power ballads give big, heavy rock bands the chance to pour their hearts out over lost loves and take a break from being big, manly men. But you Brits, you don't want to let your stiff upper lips down. I mean, you're very happy to sing a love song, as long as you don't admit that that's what it really is. Examples are I'm Not in Love by 10cc, and this next song by John Waite, who's claiming over and over again not to be missing his ex-love interest. You know, you guys really should show more of your sensitive side. This is Missing You at number 30. This is VH1's Top 50 Power Ballads, and we haven't even scratched the surface yet. Now, a lot of power ballads ride on the back of big films. You know, some artists, such as Kenny Loggins, aren't actually allowed to release songs unless they are on soundtracks. You know, if he comes up with a great song, sometimes he'll actually write an entire film around the song just so he can release it.
That's rubbish!
No, that's a true fact. This next band knew the value of attaching a song to a movie. At number 26, it's the Goo Goo Dolls and Iris from the City of Angels. Okay, so now it's time to focus our attention on the queen of power ballads. There are really only three major contenders. They are Mariah, Whitney, and Celine. But after careful consideration, I think we're going to have to give it to Celine. I mean, the other are worthy contenders, but the reason it goes to Celine is because everything she sings is a power ballad. I mean, if you asked her to sing Happy Birthday, she would do it as a power ballad. She's at number 22 with My Heart Will Go On. Hi, and welcome back to the Top 50 Power Ballads with David Hasselhoff. That's me. Coming up next is a band that uses the power ballad in order to give themselves a break during their gigs. In fact, as time has moved on, they're doing more and more power ballads. I'm not suggesting these guys are finding it a bit of a challenge to keep up these days, but their combined ages are actually 269. And there's only two. And they're cool buddies of mine. So, in at 19, it's Aerosmith and Crazy. You know, it takes a certain kind of person to be able to pull off a power ballad, and if you don't get it right, you're simply left with a ballad. But you don't have to be a big person to have a big voice. I mean, take this next young lady, for example. If she were ever required to do so, she could sing the hind legs off a donkey. She's often been given a hard time about her slightly unconventional dress sense, her ever-changing hairstyles, and her over-the-top videos. But one thing you could never criticize is her incredible voice. At number 16, it's Christina Aguilera and Beautiful. Hi, and welcome back to the Top 50 Power Ballads with David Hasselhoff. Oh, that's me. Now, there are several uses for power ballads, and one of them is so the couples can have a song. You know, when people ask them what their song is, usually they say, My Heart Will Go On from Titanic, or Everything I do it for you. I mean, if we didn't have power ballads, people would say, My song is Hey, Macarena, or Ay, Moosey. I mean, well, anyway, the next track is probably a their song for couples the world over. Whitney's at number 12 with Dolly's ultimate love ballad, I Will Always Love You. We're now inside the top 10 of our 50 power ballads. You know, if you're going to go to the trouble of doing a power ballad, you really have to back it up with a good dramatic video. These guys at number 9 use the old get a beautiful girl to star in the video, thus detracting the attention from the not-so-handsome band deal. The girl in question happened to be going out with the lead singer at the time, and rumor has it, he tried to turn the fantasy wedding into the real thing. Unfortunately for him, she declined his generous offer. It's Guns N' Roses with November Rain. You know, the majority of these songs are sung by American bands, but that doesn't mean you Brits aren't capable of knocking out the odd power ballad yourselves. I mean, we've already had John Waite, Robbie Williams, proving that. The next band are British. No, they're Irish, to be precise, but they're so successful, you guys conveniently take credit for them like you do with, you know, Lennox Lewis, Kylie Minogue. But whatever nationality he is, the lead singer has one of the most powerful voices in the business. And this has got to be one of the most haunting ballads ever. At number six, it's U2's With or Without You. Hi, I'm David Hasselhoff, and this is the Top 50 Power Ballads on VH1. The tension is really mounting now as we reach the top three, and we're deciding on number one. You know, it wasn't an easy decision, let me tell you. The next guy was definitely one of the strongest contenders. He always remembers the golden rule of attaching your song to a Kevin Costner film. And he goes to the trouble of having brackets in his songs. But unfortunately, he's not number one because his hair is not long enough. So, at number three in our chart, it's Bryan Adams with Everything I Do, bracket, I Do It For You, bracket. Okay, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. We have now reached the number one power ballad here on VH1! And no one could argue that this artist is truly the king of the power ballad. He has the long hair, he has the brackets in his song titles, he has the expensive videos, and he definitely has the extremely tight pants or trousers or slacks or whatever you call them. I am, of course, talking about the one and only Meatloaf! Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this little amble through the Power Ballad Hall of Fame. It's been fun for me, and I've been David Hasselhoff. And I'm going to leave you in the capable and sizable hands of Mr. Loaf with I Would Do Anything for Love, bracket, but I won't do that, bracket. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on TV. Thank you.